At 7 this morning, I got on the phone and said to hold my bronc as long as you can. My car broke down in Billings and they just got it put together. I'll be photo finishing in the old Cheyenne. Well, here I am in Sheridan and it's 9 o'clock in the morning and times are going fast. I just pulled her over, had some coffee and a donut, and I bought the car a brand new tank of gas. Well, I don't know if I'm gonna make it, it's 9:15, I'll be lucky if I ever get there. By God, now what's that I hear? Is it a siren? Sure enough, he got me on his radar. He pulled up behind me and turned on those flashing lights, a sign that I knew meant to pull her over. So I stomped on my brakes and as I skidded to a halt, I wiped out 3 reflector posts along the shoulder. He got out of his car and was a-walking real slow, so I jumped out and met him halfway. He jerked out his gun and said, "Mister, are you crazy? I ain't never seen nobody drive that way." I told him take it easy and he could put up that cannon. The way he's shaking, it just might go off. He put up the gun as I explained my situation. He listened to my story, then he called. He wrote me out a ticket that seemed to take forever. I took it and as I headed for my car, that cop, he hollered out to me and said, "Hey cowboy, you better slow down 'cause you can't outrun this radar." As I rolled on down the road, I was a-cursing and a-swearing about the ticket that I had just acquired. I wondered if I ought to pay it or throw it out the window, let imagine set the damn thing fire. So I gunned it once again and was a-traveling down the road with the gas pedal mashed to the floor. When I came around a curve and right there in the highway, there's more damn sheep than I've ever seen before. I'm going too fast to ever stop, so I just close my eyes as the car roars on through the herd. When I open up my eyes again, there's a sheep on the fender and that herder saying some mighty awful words. The sweat's a-dripping off my hands as I barrel through old Wheatland. I'm a nervous wreck and I must be a sight. The flies inside this old car are buzzing all around me. Guess my 24-hour deodorant quit last night. 60, 50, 40, 30, 20 miles more, the rodeo starts in another 18 minutes. I pull in through the main gate and I hear the anthem playing. I can't believe it, thank God I finally made it. There's only one more obstacle that's standing in my way. It's a nitwit with a weekend badge. He's standing by the gate and as I slide her to a halt, he says, "Where in the hell you going so doggone fast?" I tell him I'm in it and I ain't got time to talk. My horse is in the chute and I'm late. He says I need to get a pass from the secretary. My eyes get red, my heart fills up with hate. I yell, "You dirty so-and-so, you better let me through." He asked if I'd repeat that once again. So I whacked him in the mouth and then I left him lying there on his back, a-kicking in the sand. I got there just in time to see my bronc come running out. His head and tail was held way up high. I swear he looked right straight at me and grinned and gave a horse laugh. And me, I just stood there and cried. I turned around feeling helpless and purely dumbfounded. I looked and what did I see? 3 highway patrol men and a gate man with a fat lip, and they were all a-looking right at me. Sitting in the cell now, I've done a lot of thinking about that wild run I made a month ago. I'm sorry that I'm in this rotten situation. If I could do it again, I wouldn't have drove so slow. If I could do it again, I wouldn't have drove so slow.